Adding new brushes to Procreate is really easy, but it's still one of the questions I get asked the most often, so I thought I'd do a quick demo video to show you how you can do it. Now, depending on how you get the brushes onto your iPad, there's a few different methods you might encounter when importing the brushes, so we're going to look at them really quickly. And for that, I'm going to use the brushes from my free Procreate Jumpstart Kit. So feel free to pause the video here, go click on the link in the description below if you want to go ahead and download my freebie kit. Again, it includes a few brushes, so you can use those to follow along. But otherwise, these are the same step you would follow no matter where the brushes you're trying to import are coming from. Now, the first method is not really a method. It's something that's just going to happen automatically if the download or the airdrop that has your brushes in it is just the brushes. So it's not a folder with the brushes, it's not a zip file with the brushes, it's just the brushes. What's going to happen in that case is once your download is completed or once your airdrop is received, you're going to get that little pop-up window. And from there, really easy, all you have to do is select Open with Procreate. And it's going to open up Procreate. It might open the gallery, it might open a canvas, doesn't really matter. I'm just going to create a random canvas here to show you. If I go ahead now, open my brush library, I can see that at the top of the list now I have this new brush pack, which is the one I just imported. Now, in most cases, you are not going to get a pop-up window at the end of your download, and the reason for that is the brushes are probably going to be within a folder or a zip file. So your iPad doesn't recognize that it is for Procreate, and it's just going to store it within the Files app within your iPad. So all you have to do in that case, if you don't see your pop-up window, is go straight to the Files app, which is this blue folder icon right here. It is not an app you need to install. It should be already somewhere on your iPad on your home screen. So once you locate it, just open up the app. And it's going to show you a view of all the folders and the zip files you have stored on your iPad or sometimes on your iCloud, depending on your settings. So from here, it's going to be really easy to unzip any folder we might have and import the file straight into Procreate. But for that to work, we need to make sure we are in the On My iPad display. So if you are not, really easy, just go ahead and tap on this little icon here on the top left and just select On My iPad from the left-hand menu. It's probably going to show up as Recents, but if you try to unzip a file from the Recent section, it is just not going to work. So again, just make sure you are in the On My iPad view. And so just locate your file. If it is a zip file, all you have to do to unzip it is just tap on it, and the Files app is almost instantly going to open it up. In my case, you can see I have a few examples right here, but it's essentially this brush folder. So I'm just going to tap on that. And in there, I'm going to notice I have this little Procreate icon here, which is a really good sign. Now, Procreate brushes do have a few different kinds of extensions. So if it is a brush pack, you're going to see that the extension is brush set. But if it is a single brush, so not a category or brush, it's just going to be the extension brush. As long as there's a little Procreate icon, you're good to go. So just go ahead and tap on the file you want to import. Again, it's going to open up Procreate just like it did in method one. And if we go ahead, open up the brush library again, we're going to see that this new pack is now at the top of my list. So nature pack, and now I have my brushes. Now, one last little note, if you are importing a single brush, so not a brush pack, meaning the extension just brush and not brush set, if you're hoping for that brush to show up at the top of the list, you're going to wait a long time because single brushes in Procreate are now imported in a folder that is automatically created by the app, and that folder is at the very bottom of the list. It is called Imported, and that's where all your single brushes that you import are going to show up. So brush packs are going to show up again at the top, but single brushes are going to show up in this imported folder at the bottom. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn how to create your own signature stem brush just like this one, I highly recommend you check out this video because I'm going to show you exactly how you can do it step by step. It is really super easy. But before you leave, make sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of the weekly videos I post every Tuesday and Saturday. Then click on the link right here and I'll meet you there.